Excuse me. All right, let's share this. Okay. Ah, bummer. I didn't hook up my secondary webcam. And that's okay. I just gotta move these hard drives somewhere. I don't want to break them by accident. See, ideally, we would have two webcams hooked up simultaneously. I would definitely prefer that, because I would point one webcam down. And if I could find it, I might have a second web. Don't fall. Ah, good, we do have two webcams here. We might be able to pull this off. Say it's a big maybe. That makes such an ugly sound. I'm gonna try to make this happen. I don't know. Don't bump. Okay. Zip ties are a little tricky to operate when you use them for the wrong thing. Okay. Oof, what a mess. I don't know if this will work, but I'm trying to make it work. Okay, so we just gotta rotate this. Alright, let's see if this secondary web camera works. Sitting a little close right now because I have a VCR in my chair. Where's my secondary camera? Alright, so... we got it! Okay, secondary webcam? Yeah, alright. I just wish I had a lamp here. It's a little sloppily done here. Obviously. What we want is to have a camera looking down on this desk, because this is where we are going to disassemble. I may not wear my headphones for this one, but they're not completely necessary, and this keyboard is more of a encumbrance. I should have gotten the cordless version of this keyboard. You know, I mean, I don't believe in wireless headphones for everything, but wireless keyboards, why not? Alrighty, let's get this off here. Well, at least nobody's watching yet. We do have a VCR hooked up, and in fact, I am hoping it works. Okay. Let's switch camera views for a moment. Okay, full. What the? Bugger! Okay, whoops. I see what happened here. Okay, so we gotta switch the webcam. Then we gotta go to secondary webcam. Delete or disable. Put in our secondary webcam. We'll call it camera 2. Excuse you. Okay, now let's put camera one into the mix. Copy pasta. Paste it right here. We can do this. All right, we'll put me in the corner. Well, let's test out a VCR. We'll put 1994 ice skating. Okay, so I may have to make some minor adjustments. Quite a few adjustments here. Okay, so let's see here. We gotta transform it. 1280 by 960, was it? Mm-hmm. 1440 by 1080. That is the correct resolution if you're trying to do 1080p 4x3 video. Oof, that is atrocious video tracking right here. Look at that. See, if I had a remote control for this VCR, we could use a button or something to adjust our tracking. I wouldn't be surprised if holding the channel buttons down together. One Mississippi, two Mississippi. Oh, it did it automatically, I believe, too. See, that's a not too uncommon function of old video. So let's go to Whoops. Where is it? Okay. Let's see what we can do here. All right, number one. I want this VCR to not be a pain in my butt. We're gonna start recording now. Okay, look at that. So the tracking looked like it corrected itself like a second. With old VCRs, you would have a setting called tracking, and with any VCR, you would have a tracking control, which would adjust the vertical position of your tape with relation to the tape head. And what many VCRs would do is they would let you hold down a couple of the buttons. Like if you were not, you know, changing the channel, they might say in the manual, hold down the channel up and channel down button. Sometimes this would trigger automatic tracking. Other times it would allow you to, oh, see, like it's getting worse. So that's a good sign that I'm in manual control. And it looks like it's working. And then all I gotta do is make sure my audio is unmuted so that I can hear my VCR. And I cannot hear the VCR for some reason. It could be because I hooked the audio up incorrectly. It could be because I gotta enable something. It could be because of the tracking. Yeah, I should be getting sound. What is going on here? It says hi-fi. Of course, I cannot see my video corrector box here, nor can you. Here we are, this box here. I really need to hook a light up over here. So we have this box here, it's called a video corrector box, and we have the audio up. We can switch our input. We can enhance the picture. We got John Madden selling hardware. You can change the color. But all I want is to hear the bass line or regular sound. I don't want to do anything fancy yet. So let me take a look here, see what I'm overlooking. It's gotta be the output, because if I yank this plug, I don't get output. So we know we're getting output. So that's a start. But why are we not getting sound? We have my analog video capture device here. We've got yellow, white, and red. Those are connected. And we're gonna go and check something. USB video capture device. Capture audio. Use custom audio device, even so though this is not necessary.
physique and athletic ability, and they've all fulfilled my definition of what it takes to make a great skater.
We're getting some
and that is one who not only reaches the top but leaves the sport different and better just because he or she was in it.
I can't
so you pick your favorite, whether it's Torval and Dean or Brian Boitano or Christy Yamaguchi or whomever.
I can hear
for
it
me
now.
Well, I like them all, including the ones I have the softest spot in my heart for, the older ones.
See, this was
one
much
of my favorites.
Easier when I was using the
and tonight it's a USB, rare opportunity
I'm sorry, the HDMI input, the Elgato, and I still have it. I mean,
let's
I'm not getting rid of
now
it,
for her thoughts, Peggy.
But I'm choosing
Julie,
to use
this.
This
sure brings back memories.
Okay, good,
and
we got sound now. Well, I got sound. You probably could hear this.
That feeling of wanting to do
I'm
going to
lower this a little bit.
I guess it's also part of that competitive spirit. I've become more accustomed to the sideline role of commentary today. But these
Man, this sucks. This keyboard is like destined to be tangled up with everything. Oh my gosh. 1968, man. She must be old now. Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay. That'll do. I really shouldn't have this microphone so close to me. Okay, there we go. Now let's proceed. Nobody tuning in yet? Alright, well anyway, I gotta fix something here. Why am I getting mono sound here? Why am I not getting stereo? I'm only hearing it on my left channel, and you can clearly see here it's only coming through the left channel. Why?
He skates like a Mercury with wings and his blades. He's known for tight, quick steps, even tighter jumps, and very spiffy moves.
Okay, so I'm looking at the settings. Yeah, I got no audio control for this yet. Well, I guess we're gonna just check the cables. We're gonna yank one channel out at a time. Left channel coming out. Okay, left channel is gone. We're gonna plug in the wrong channel on purpose. Okay, so we got left. Well, that's bloody weird. That is weird. I bet it's a automatic feature. I think this VCR is not outputting stereo sound. Well, that is weird. Either the VCR is not outputting stereo sound. Whoa. What is going on here? Let's see here. We'll try some experiments here. Nope. Okay, not a surprise. Okay, plug your ears up, y'all. We're gonna make an ugly sound. That was ugly. See, I told you it would be ugly. Okay, so we got picture. We're gonna plug our left channel in. Oh! Okay, good. We got stereo sound back. Very good. Well, adequate. Well, actually, okay. So now, my video corrector box has some knobs here. We can amplify the video and audio together. We can amplify video or reduce it.
And now, a golden memory from Lincoln Mercury. In 1984, Scott Hamilton brought his brilliant amateur career to a close and won the gold medal at the Winter Games in Sarajevo, he became only the fourth American male to be so honored.
Sophisticated engineering has made Lincoln Continental a surprisingly smart luxury sedan. In fact, it even knows a lot about you. It knows how long your legs are. It knows the sound of your voice.
Call Tom.
Thank you.
Why, with its load-leveling suspension, Continental even knows exactly how much you weigh. But don't worry, it also knows how to stay quiet.
What I'm trying to do is make sure that the left and right audio channels are, you know, balanced.
It doesn't look like a Polaroid camera.
It's not a Polaroid camera.
Presenting the Polaroid Captiva. It's sleek, it's stylish. Its pocket-sized pictures stay in a special compartment till you take them out, so you're free to shoot and shoot.
Maybe if you shake it.
Yeah, shake the camera.
The Polaroid Captiva. The pictures stay in till you take them out.
Oh, let's put my light on.
I never realized the world was so full of hazards. That's why there's
there we go.
Met life, because sometimes things do get out of control. That's why over 45 million people look.
I think the sound is good enough for the VCR. Now we can go ahead and grab a screwdriver that I have since misplaced. I've misplaced it upon
this
sitting down,
brilliant.
Apparently.
Leave it to Clairol. It's not a new hair color. No, it's another shampoo.
Oh, that stinks. I mean, I was ready to go here.
The way to hold on to perfect color. Between colors.
I'm ready to rock and roll.
And conditioners. Plus the choice of weekly conditioner. It keeps my blonde brilliant. My red.
Okay. We're ready to roll. So basically, the plan. I inserted a tape while the VCR was not plugged in. And when I did plug it in, the mechanism was half engaged, so now the tape is stuck. On top of that, I kind of hit the play button, and the tape wrapped itself around the tape head. If you don't know what this means, you'll find out in a minute. I'm hoping this is not a big pain in the butt. I dropped it. Got it. Come on.
What a pleasure to see her here tonight.
Wow.
She was succeeded by Mary Carol Heiss in 1960 and Peggy Fleming in 1968. Then came Dorothy. On Valentine's Day in 1976 at the Innsbruck Winter Games, Dorothy Hamill became...
Oh, Dorothy Hamill. Luke Hamill's mom.
And she has done it, I am sure. It's the competition.
Alrighty, let's proceed. Oh, we gotta take a screw out from here.
Was, you know, the previous American.
Ah, Ms. Yamaguchi.
I think every little girl back then wanted to be like her. So I had the Dorothy Hamill doll, and I thought she had a lot of energy, and it was fun to watch.
There we go. We're in. Okay, so, yep, no surprise here. Tape is wrapped around the tape head. In other words, this is going to be a humongous pain in the butt. Man, this is going to stink. You can see it's all over here. So I guess my safest bet is to literally remove this. Oh gosh. This is just a tremendous catastrophe. Come on. I'm not even sure how I'm gonna do this. See, I'm trying to avoid disassembling the entire Hoovy Watch's assembly here. I really don't like doing that part. I mean, I guess we're gonna begin. There we go. Okay. Let's proceed. Yeah. Good thing it's not plugged in. See, this is one of those mechanisms where taking the screw out doesn't necessarily let you take out the part you want to take out. So I can do this, I can bring it up like this, but it's gonna do ugly things to the tape. See, we got the tape out mostly, but now we got it wrapped around this rubber wheel here. And there is a trick to this part. There's a number of tricks to this part. We're gonna do some ugly things to the tape right now. This tape will probably never play the same again. What tape is it? Home Movies. Ah, bummer. Okay, good thing I recorded. I think that I recorded this tape twice on the computer. So worst case scenario, I could digitally splice the messed up part if I can't recover decent footage. I just want this wheel here to get out of my way. Oh, we got it. Okay, so there we go. So now we can manually wind this tape back in. Whew, it's a little wrinkly here, but what can we do? It's magnetic, so hopefully it'll work itself out. We'll take the smoother side and wind it in first. Now we must unlock it. So we put a screwdriver in here. Got it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to iron the tape flat by fast forwarding it manually a few revs. And then we're going to rewind it inside of this VCR, as a matter of fact, which is probably a little bit not a good idea because this is a family home footage here. So I think we're going to go ahead and mute the audio. I don't know. I mean, I kind of, you know what? Yeah, I'm going to mute the audio just in case. Sorry, guys. Oh. Okay. There we go. Now we're gonna put this tape inside. It's very funny how the newer the VCR, the crappier the features. Okay, audio is looking good. We're gonna gradually fast forward. In the meantime, we're gonna try to figure out why the door is still open. This door should close automatically. Maybe I need to plug it in and then unplug it. Well, this VCR is supposed to be newer and better, but it's making some ugly sounds. It is making, it could just be like a magically high speed mechanism that makes ugly sounds, but okay, there it is. The mechanism has retracted, but we still have some stuff here, some issues. And I don't know what tape I want to use, but yeah, screw it. We're going to go and go for broke. We're going to shove the 1994. It doesn't really matter, does it? Looks like this VCR doesn't want to accept the tape until we could get this mechanism to go back into its original position. See, like, got all these pieces here. You got this piece here. So all of these pieces kind of just mesh together to work together to make stuff happen. And I've had to do this once before. It was absolutely annoying. I think what I did was I had to, there was like a gear. Oh yeah, here we are. No, was it this? I remember I manually moved some kind of motor or belt or something, and it kind of, here, oh, that looks good. There we go, we did it. Okay, so now we're gonna go ahead. We're gonna put these screws back in. And you know, this wasn't even my first choice. I mean, this VCR has been very good to me over the years, but years ago my parents replaced it with the black VCR, which is on my bed. And the black VCR is very similar to this silver Panasonic here, being that they were like late VCRs. I'm talking like, if this VCR was bought in 1998, the black VCR was bought in like 2001 or 2002. The silver VCR was bought probably even later. Oh god, dude. Don't get stuck, please don't cause a problem, please don't cause a problem, please don't cause a problem. Okay, so that was a close call, but basically this mechanism said, F me. We might be able to get this mechanism to go back, but it's not gonna cooperate with us just yet. It wants us to do more to it. Ow, almost lost a finger here. So, yeah, there's a trick to this here. Okay, we turned on the VCR. Some little mechanism just did some mechatronic action here. Oh my gosh, I do not like this. Okay, so this piece here doesn't want to be moved yet. Something here, something is, well, obviously something isn't cooperating with us yet. Could be this thing here, could be this thing here, you know what I mean? Yeah. There it is. So, see that? There's this gear that does some weird action here. And there might be a gear on the opposite side. I'll give it a shot. I really should put like a blank. Oh, please. No? Very weird, the tape head is spinning, but it's not ready to work yet. There is something else in this mechanism. Oh, I remember now. I think it's something even more absurd than we would like it to be. So I have to manually move this gear. Don't do anything yet. Okay, I'm talking to the VCR. I have to manually move this gear. And then I have to move the gear over like this. Then I have to do something with the belt drive here. Something. Okay, but the door is closed. If I hit the play button, nothing happens. But that's because the VCR turned off. Okay, good. That's good. So the mechanism has wrapped the tape correctly around the tape head. The VCR is still on, and when I hit the power button, It's working. Kind of. It's just kind of gave up on us, but that is progress. We can probably eject the tape. Please eject. Go. Please don't fucking. Oh, Jesus. Okay, good. Thank God. Okay, so we have hope here. We're gonna try something. We're gonna turn it on. Okay, so I tightened up the tape. God, this. Okay, so it's playing. But for some reason, the mechanism is not gonna eject the tape correctly. Alright, that is very scary. This is gonna suck. This is gonna suck. I'm cringing right now because it's gonna do some ugly things to the tape again. See, what is that BS? Oh, maybe. I don't know. I might have done something. I might have engaged a mechanism or something. I don't like this VCR anymore. Alright, we're gonna do something risque. We're gonna eject this tape. We're gonna forcibly eject this tape if it doesn't come out. Okay, I know what we're gonna do now. We're gonna turn this. We're gonna let this mechanism move. Then we're gonna turn off the VCR abruptly. We're gonna say, turn off! And if this doesn't work, I'm gonna pull the power cord out. Alright, it's not ideal, but it could work. Oh god. Oh, yeah. Stay like that, you piece of junk. I don't care if the thing is half engaged. I'd rather it be more cooperative. So now we're gonna manually see this. I can move this gear. And as weird as it is, I can sort of progress it along like this. We do some ugly things to the tape again, but can't really be helped. But this time we were able to be a little more graceful about it because, you know, the only issue is closing the door on the edge of the tape. That, oh god, that is ugly. Good thing, I mean, who cares about the freaking 1994 ice skating competition, you know? But still, I mean, I would not have wanted to ruin it. Okay, so we got that part. Now, all right, so how's about we say screw this VCR for now until we have a blank tape that we don't care about, because I'm not shoving my Babylon 5 tape in there. Because I mean, look, maybe this VCR will offer some superior functionality. I don't think it will. I'm not really in the mood. Hey, Punk Water, what up? Yeah, right? But yeah, man, so I got this black VCR, same concept as this guy here, and I'm probably gonna use that. But what I was doing, I'll show you real quick in case you got to pop out, unless you already left. You'll see these horizontal lines called scan lines, and when I use my HDMI input, it's the HDMI upscaler. There's actually, you know, the adapter from VCR composite to HDMI. It takes away the scan lines automatically, and it does some other things to the video quality, which supposedly make it better. But what I'm doing now is I'm using an older USB video capture device, not very old. And this one does not remove the scan lines. It lets you kind of deal with that in post-processing, like if you're re-encoding your video. And I'm using this one because my video corrector box on my desk here lets me control the quality a bit more, lets me amplify the signal a bit more and stuff when I don't use an upscaler. Upscalers do weird things to the video signal, apparently. But like the title says, I accidentally put a tape into this VCR while it was not plugged in, and the stupid tape got jammed. And then while shaking this VCR, I had my black VCR on top of it, and I shook my black VCR, and somehow that caused it to malfunction too. So I luckily dug up this silver guy, which is my newest VCR. Also, the newer they get, the less they weigh. They get lighter and lighter. This VCR, though, has the coolest front panel. Like, it's got the knob on it. It's got the shuttle knob. It's got extra buttons. It's got, like, an extra input on the front. It's got a feature called AV CompuLink, whatever that does. I think it puts, like, markers on the tape like a playlist. So, long story short, I'm going to be converting some tapes. I'm going to record them through OBS, because OBS basically does what Virtual Dub does, except it's newer and it's being supported. And we're going to pray that my black VCR still works, because I like that one more. And if it doesn't, I'll go and use the silver VCR, because I really don't want to be fighting with the mechanism inside of this particular VCR. Even though this is a great VCR, I don't want to fight with it. So that's the game plan. Nothing too interesting going on, but, you know, I figured I'd make a stream out of it, because then I'm not talking to myself. I mean, even if nobody's in the chat, I can pretend that I'm talking to an audience, so it doesn't look like I'm as crazy as I am. And that is what I am doing. But this VCR, we're not going to fight with it. We're just going to put it together, put it somewhere, put it away for now. Fight with the mechanism later. I should really leave a note on it telling myself to not put a tape in it until I'm ready to take it apart again. In fact, I should put a note on this VCR saying don't put an important tape inside. And what I really wanted to do tonight was I wanted to play an episode of Urkel, or not, you know, I just wanted to put in the TGIF lineup, because many years ago I recorded, well, I didn't record it, my dad recorded TGIF. If you remember, Channel 7, or that's Channel 7 New York, ABC, had a lineup called TGIF. And you had, like, Urkel, you had Family Matters, Step by Step. Wow, what the heck am I playing here? I really should put something more mainstream. You want to watch, well, it doesn't matter. I'm sure you've already moved on from the viewing, but, yeah, like, I mean, I got a Communion here. And that is a 1985 Chevy Celebrity. That was a car made by Chevy, available as both a sedan and a station wagon. We had the station wagon model. And apparently my brother watched some Bruce Lee back in the day. Or something, I guess. I mean, is that? Yeah, it's not me. That's definitely not me. Is it? No, it's not me. So, yeah. And then there was a people in the 90s. Look in the background. You see a person in the 90s dressed like the 90s. That's why I put the home videos in, so that we could watch people from the 90s in the background. Oh, a Chevy. Not a Chevy. A Volare. Oh, that car was... Look at that piece of shit. Had, like, a rusted door on it. And then the paint job was, like, a copper finish. Yeah, that's my mom in the zebra dress, apparently. I think that's zebra. But yeah, that Volare, man, that car was a hoot. So it looks like we're walking to the church right now. Oh yeah, that's me, my little Guido ass there with the curly hair. And our church looks kind of hip and modern for its time, if I don't say so myself. But yeah, man, I got downstairs. I left it downstairs, but after I work out these issues with the VCR playback, you know, I want to make sure that I can put a tape into the VCR and that it will not cause any tracking errors. It won't jam up. I won't get that buzzing sound. You know, when you put a VCR tape and the tracking is off, you get that buzzing sound. So let's see here. We got Lake George, 1988. Here we are. Robin Williams, Jumanji. I believe that was supposed to be Jumanji, but it says Umanji on it. We got Jumanji, Lawnmower Man, and GoldenEye. This must be one of those tapes recorded in EP mode, so that you can squeeze 6 hours out of it. Now, this one says Spring 95 program, but the lettering is very faded. This was a public access TV show my mom did back in the late 90s. Ah, here we are. Earth Final Conflict and Star Trek The Next Generation. I wanted to really, obviously we have Star Trek episodes and I have Earth Final Conflict, and I'm pretty sure the quality of my download is pretty good. But what I wanted to see is, and we'll put the audio back on if it's not already on. Yeah, we got audio. See, there we go. Was the commercial is when you have like a news episode and they have the announcer saying, next time on Star Trek, Deep Space Nine, you know. They have the coming attractions. That's why I was playing this. But we got a little problem here. It looks like this tape has such messed up tracking. I don't know. I think this particular VCR has some sketchy tracking issues on it. So my black VCR seems to be the I don't know if you can hear that. This VCR makes ugly noises when you rewind the tape. I mean, maybe it needs a little bit of lithium grease on it. Of course, I have. Okay, that's not bad. Let's see. We'll adjust the video corrector box. I forgot all about these weird Got Milk commercials. E-business. What's an e-business? This is an e-business. So I'm just trying to think here. This is an e-business. Yeah, I gotta get the black VCR. I'm afraid to press the rewind button on it. I don't like this VCR. It makes ugly noises. Okay, so this VCR, it didn't jam my tapes, which is good. Is that Kurt Russell? Is that that movie we were told about on one of the streams the other day? I think on Nerdporeal, they mentioned a show called The Soldier with Kurt Russell in it. It took place in the Alien universe, or supposedly it took place in the Alien universe, but let's see if Kurt Russell shows up again. Nah, it's Species 2. That movie was interesting. I love the movie Species. Okay, man, you roll out like an Autobot. You know, like I said, I just wanted to stream while fighting with my VCR, but I'm sure I'll have some interesting uploads soon. I'm not sure if I'm going to start a separate channel, but you have a good evening, Prunk Waddle. Thank you. I got a triple monitor set up here. Alrighty, whoops, uh-oh, what did I just do? Okay, good. Okay, let's see how far we get now. Oh, did I eject it? Alright, let's see if this VCR works now. Okay. Before, it would just make this noise. Alright, one Mississippi, two Mississippi. Please work. Okay, good, it works. Okay, that VCR was acting temperamental before, but I'm just generally more comfortable with this VCR at the moment, because it gave me consistent results earlier. It didn't eat up any tapes. These are usually positive things when a VCR does not eat tapes. I have this thing about VCRs that eat my tapes up. I tend to have trust issues when a VCR eats the tapes. But when a VCR doesn't eat tapes, well, then I tend to trust it a bit more. So now I can go back to my original plan, which was very simple. I need to compare footage. Okay, so we've successfully removed the jammed tape from the VCR. And I think I'm going to end this stream unless I have something interesting to do later, like play a video game. I also want to check if other friendly YouTubers are presently running their own streams. We do have the moon out tonight, but it's kind of hazy and cloudy up in the sky, so I'm not going to do an astronomy stream, but we're going to check up on who is running what, looks like. Okay. Nah, nobody's doing anything right now. It's just a guy, a journalist guy, and somebody who's got bad news in the family. Oh, two YouTubers have bad news. One guy had sudden infant death. The other guy, apparently, I don't know, he's one of the prepping community members. He's got something sad to tell. It looks sad on the thumbnail. I hope he's okay. I guess I'll watch it and find out. But yeah, I mean, you know, it got me thinking about it. Like, you know, I mean, sudden infant death is syndrome. It's not like an actual thing on its own. I mean, sure, the fact that if you have an infant and they die instantly, yeah, that's sudden infant death. But I don't know, this whole syndrome thing, I mean, like, I guess we feel we have to, you know, I mean, the medical community likes to put names on things. Autopsy reports have names, and, you know, I get it. Like, it's just simpler than trying to go blobby blah blah blah, but I mean, yeah, sure, a baby died suddenly, but there's got to be something else to it, you know. I mean, heck, sudden infant death and gradual infant death was much more common in the old world. Back in the day, if you had a kid, and you wouldn't name the kid for the first year. People would not name their kids for like a year because there was no guarantee that they would make it a year, so you would just, you know, kind of wing it, and then if they survived a year, you'd be like, okay, we'll give you a name now, because I guess the idea back then was not to get too attached to your newborn or your offspring until you know that they had a chance at it, and even then, they could catch a cold, catch tuberculosis or some crazy crap. But I was wondering, I had some speculation about the sudden death. I really hope this guy's infant didn't get any particular brand new medical intervention, relatively new intervention for something that an infant is at low risk of. I mean, I know what country he lives in, and it's not the US, it's not the third world, it's a very good country. I mean, but I don't know, I'm not going to speak on this, I don't want to speculate more, but I'll do my homework, and I'm not going to keep my mouth shut. It's a private matter for this YouTuber, but you know, my thoughts and prayers are with that particular YouTuber who lost his infant son. And yeah, I say thoughts and prayers. You know, I hate, I get it, but I also dislike it when people bitch and moan, saying, you know, like mocking thoughts and prayers like it's a bad thing. And it's like, I get it, if you're not religious, you don't care for prayers. But the fact of the matter is, the religious person went out of their way to say thoughts and prayers, you know, like, for the sake of the non-religious people, they tried to accommodate, and people still have to be dicks about it. So I always found that to be kind of amusing and annoying. But I get it, thoughts and prayers don't do much for people. You know, people want action. They want them to go to a protest. They want them to take financial action, donate money. I don't know what people want. I mean, frankly, you can do anything. People will always bitch about it. So, you know, you can't make people happy. But I always found it amusing when people whined about the use of the term thoughts and prayers. But I think it's a reasonable thing, because even if you're religious, you know, if somebody's in your prayers, they are also in your thoughts. And if they're in your thoughts, maybe if you're quiet about your religion, maybe they're in your prayers, or maybe you have an alternative way of conducting prayer, you know? That's in, you know, personal business, you know, it's one's individual choice. So, yeah. I don't know why I brought that up, but, you know, I you know, he's a YouTuber, he talks about space. I don't watch all of his videos, sometimes they're long and boring to me, but sometimes he'll read an article that's interesting, and he's got a lot of viewers, so I'm happy for the guy. I mean, not happy for him in his current state of affairs. So, you know, he's going to take a week or two off, and hopefully when he returns, he'll be able to pick up his spirits, but I'd imagine it's a tough time for both him and his wife, so, you know, like I said, he's in my thoughts and prayers, and if you know which YouTube I'm talking about, he's like a friendly Russian guy who lives in, who does not live in Russia, because of course everyone's got to boycott Russia now, so yeah, you know, keep him in your thoughts. Alright, y'all have a good evening, and I shall return if I feel like it later, and if I'm not disrupting other people's streaming. End stream.